pop-up stores have become the norm in holiday retailing. This Spirit Halloween store opens for just 2 months and then it's gone. Tom Frame is the regional sales manager.
We look for vacant spots. Some of the places, like the one we're in today, we've been in this location for 6 years. So the public has come to expect us to be in this location, and it's very good. So we constantly look for big box stores, generally near other retailers that will have good traffic flow into them. So it'll attract people, you know, by our store so they can see the Halloween goods that we have this time of year. But these are just seasonal operations. They're put up near the end of August, and we'll run them till about the second day of November, and then we pack everything up and go home. All the employees are temporary. We hire about 20,000 employees nationwide. Yeah, we hire them in September, and we get rid of them in November, so we have a big unemployment factor, too. You know, 20,000 people employed for a seasonal job, much like the Christmas season for other businesses. We just use it for the Halloween season.
For people who prefer to shop locally and support the arts at the same time, theater-quality costumes can be rented from the Lansing Civic Players. Laura Croft manages the costume shop.
We've been a provider for the public for rental for over 30 years, and the Lansing Civic Players has been in existence for 83 years. This is our 83rd season. We just have long been part of our community, and the community has embraced us. And at this point, it's a lot of people searching out something different, something that you can't find somewhere else for Halloween. Well, I've guesstimated about 20,000 pieces is what we've got as far as costume pieces. That does not include all the accessories. That would be upwards of 50, 60,000 if we added all of that in. A lot of our pieces are real vintage. So even if it was a costume created, it might have been created in 1952 for whatever show was playing then. So it's a vintage piece now.